Gandhi said that whatever you do in life will be insignificant. But it's very important that you do it.
Officer, those two were just trying to stop it.
Go home.
Hey, don't.
I tend to agree with the first part.
You could do worse than have a father who bails you out of jail.
I don't want to be bailed out of it.
So, Ralph, first of all, I'd like to start out by politely asking you to please ask me no personal questions. I just don't want to get into it, and I don't want to make it awkward. So I just thought we'd go ahead and start out with that.
Just please, please don't ask me any questions. I just can't handle it.
22 is a weird age. You know, your character turns 22 in the movie. I just recently turned 22, and you're not far off from 22. Is it weird having to kind of go through all of that off screen and on screen at the same time while you're trying to deal with all of this?
Yeah, I mean, I thought that's one of the main reasons I did the movie. It's kind of like going to therapy. I mean, you kind of, you have like 10 people around you, like discussing what it is to mature and stuff. And it's like, what do you think he's thinking at this point? And I was like, do you mean what do you think I'm thinking? Yeah, I mean, it was kind of helpful. I mean, I felt like I was going through the same kind of, you're kind of moving from adolescence to being a man, I guess. And I think that's in a lot of ways that's what the story's about. And I felt it was easier to do that. I always try and pick movies which will kind of, cover the same thing I'm going through at that point in my life.
Why do you think Dad doesn't want to spend time with me?
She knows I'll take care of her. That's all there is, Tyler.
That's all there is? Not enough.
You know you can't smoke in here.
Why do you have an ashtray?
It's a bowl. It completes the room.
I guess it was just here to tease me.
You've been a ghost past couple of weeks, all right? You don't want to go out anymore. I had enough of this introvert stuff, okay? I'm ready to set up an intervention here.
He has got a daughter.
Who's got a daughter?
The cop that busted your face all up. He's got a daughter.
I know her. She's in my global politics class.
Go get her.
I don't date sociology majors.
Lucky for you, I'm undecided.
About what?
Everything.
You know, I love kind of the choice that your character has to make in this movie. You know, he can either go one or two directions. He can kind of remain in an emotional lockdown and kind of like live in a bubble, or he can, you know, live a life and go out and take risks. Is that something that, I mean, do you relate to? I mean, do you have to make choices like that going one way or the other?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, but at the same time, it's not really a choice. I don't think you can really make a choice, like one single choice, to sort of live your life in a completely different way. I think in a lot of ways, what Tyler's dealing with is just accepting his life around him. I mean, I think, you know, he's not really living at the beginning, and and thinks everything should be more complicated, and everything should be deeper. Everything, you know, nothing about the way he feels about things is right. And I think by the end, he kind of sort of accepts that, you know, what is, whatever will be, and it's kind of a good way to live.
What desserts do you have?
I have my dessert first.
What is that?
This is our appetizer.
That's why chicks dig you, man. They love this freaky, poetic crap.
Charles, it's your son.
Yeah, I was wondering if you want to have dinner.
How many?
Three.
He can stand me up, but he can't stand you up.
You gotta take care of nothing! You're responsible for no one! You're a kid!
Now, I know, you know, from talking with you that you're very hard on yourself when it comes to your work. What does it take for you to be happy with your work?
I don't know. I mean, I guess to feel when you're shooting it that nothing else was hindering you. I mean, that self-consciousness wasn't hindering you, or lack of research, or lack of, work to begin with. I mean, yeah, I think that's the only reason. I mean, it's done. You can't do anything about it. But I mean, it's just when you're shooting it, if just little things, if you're not prepared, then I guess that's when I'm not particularly happy with it.
I'm going out.
Who are you going with?
A boy from school.
You're kind of lost, aren't you?
You think you know me, you don't.
My dad just doesn't know what's going on right now.
What's going on right now?
Been trying to tell me something. Make her yours forever. And I'm working on the forever part.
Okay. John, this is Jake Hamilton from Houston, First Page.
Thank you.
Where are they from?
Thank you. Express, I think. And I'm terrible at this kind of stuff. And so I had actually someone come with me and pick it up.